Joining me now from Gulf Shores, Alabama, director of the Center for Terrorism Law at St. Mary's University, Jeffrey Atticott. Jeff, yeah, there should be prayers. There should be prayers for a wall. The president has plenary power, and this is a moment in time where we ought to consider the president using these plenary powers. In fact, the president mused about it on Twitter. He said, if the Democrats do not give us the votes to secure our country, the military will build the remaining sections of the wall. Why not? It was just revealed today, Jeff, that the president has information that they arrested, what was it, a half a dozen terrorists at the border? So they're not all coming here to work. Why not employ the military? We did it, I don't, dozens of years ago and built this corrugated fencing along. It was the Army Corps of Engineers that built this corrugated fencing that exists still today, that they're, you know, ripping apart and going through. Why not employ the military?
Well, if you're serious about border security, you need to have a secure border. And, you know, obviously this is a political issue as well, but part of border security has to include a wall. The facts are the facts. When you build a wall, you'll see that the center of gravity shifts from those that want to illegally enter the country to another part. So, of course, it works. And so the president, of course, has the authority as the commander-in-chief to deal with threats to the external, external threats to the United States. And, you know, depending on how big the threat is perceived and how big it becomes, the president has unilateral authority to use the military. But he certainly is using the military in a way that the military right now is not really designed to be used. That's what, you know, that's what our border agents are supposed to do, but they're stretched too thin. So, you know, the president's making these very hard determinations. And then, of course, as you know, we have the Posse Comitatus Act. We have the domestic rule of law in terms of what law enforcement can do. And then we have a different set of rules for what the military can and can't do. So it's very confusing for a lot of people. The Congress is adding to that confusion.
It is. And I would argue that Congress is abdicating its job. It's Article I duty to secure the border and repel invasions, which is what we are seeing at the border. And then we have the third branch of government that's gone completely rogue in some cases, where these federal court judges are shutting down efforts by the president to execute the laws of the land. And I've argued on this program, maybe it's time to declare a national emergency. The president does have awesome powers to declare such a thing, because when you look at it, the troops at the border right now, their hands are tied. And you mentioned this, the Posse Comitatus Act. And this is over a 100-year-old act, and it reads in part, whoever, except in cases and under circumstances expressly authorized by the Constitution or Act of Congress, willfully uses any part of the Army or the Air Force as a posse comitatus or otherwise to execute the laws shall be fined under this title and imprisoned not more than 2 years or both. This is a post-Civil War document, act, law, and it was never intended to prevent our troops from defending our border.
No, it wasn't. In fact, the history of the Posse Comitatus Act, no one has ever been prosecuted. No one's ever been fined in the years since it's been passed. But it's become incorporated into our rule of law, if you will, for the military, where we cannot engage in arrests or searches and seizures. But we can do about everything else. And the military, of course, never gives up its inherent right to defend itself. And again, the president has to make these determinations about how to secure the border. He's all for legal immigration, as I think all Americans are. I think it enriches the country. But what we're opposed to is illegal immigration. It's so fundamentally logical that I think the American people are going to be very disappointed if they don't see the Democrat-controlled Senate and the Republican, House and the Republican-controlled Senate get together and pass some common sense legislation to stop this flow of illegal aliens into our country.
Let's further talk about the use of the United States military at the border. There's a cabinet order out there issued by John Kelly, the chief of staff for President Trump, and it reads, the Department of Defense military personnel to protect border agents, including a show or use of force, including lethal force where necessary, crowd control, temporary detention, and cursory search. What about, Jeff, the use of force, deadly force or otherwise, by the United States military, especially when you have these laws that exist that kind of tie their hands?
Well, you're right, Graham. And your first point is well taken, that we have the Department of Homeland Security has identified at least 500 criminals in that organ, in that group at the border, Tijuana. And that's just the ones they know of. And so this order gives the authority to the military. It gives authority they already have. It just restates that authority in a piece of paper, because they never give up the right to defend themselves. and to use lawful force, commensurate with the type of aggression that they're receiving.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.